Hi, this is Topher with Winning WP. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started with the Yoast SEO WordPress plugin. I'd like to take a look at the Yoast SEO plugin with you and go over a little bit about what it does. Why do we need it? We're looking here at WordPress.org at the Yoast plugin page. And there's quite a bit of information here about what it does and why you need it and why you might need to pay for the premium version. Now, WordPress relies on themes to do basic SEO. If a theme is well written, it will do well with basic SEO. And if it's not well written, it will do pretty terrible. So it leaves it up to the theme creator to do things like make good headers and put content in the right place. But when you get right down to it, the thing that makes your site unique, the thing that makes your site come up in search results, is your content. And the best thing that Yoast does for you is allow you to manipulate the SEO on a per post or page basis. So we're looking at a post here, and we come down, and there's this Yoast SEO box. And we can manipulate the page title, the description, and all sorts of things. We'll take a better look at that in just a few minutes. But the key here to remember is that the Yoast SEO plugin really comes in handy when you're customizing the SEO for each post and page. This means that the plugin isn't something you simply install, change some settings, and leave forever. Every time you make a post or page, you need to do a little bit of work with Yoast SEO to make that post and page really stand out. Now, before we install Yoast, we need to set up a special kind of Google account at the Google Search Console. It used to be called Google Webmaster Tools, and you'll still see evidence of that here at the top and in the URL. But there's a big button here that says Search Console. Now you can get to this page with Google. Just search for Google Search Console. You're also going to need a Google account. But one of the great things about Google accounts is that they work across all of Google properties. So if you already have a YouTube account or a Gmail account, you can use that. If you don't, you can create one here. I'm going to click Sign In. And if you didn't already have one, then this is where you could create one. I'm going to choose my Google account. And here I am. Now, if this was your first time, you wouldn't see any websites listed here. I have several. But you would see an Add a Property button. So we'll click that. And then they want to know the web address of the site that we're going to be working with. Just put in your address and click Add. And that's all we have to do for right now with Google Search Console. We're going to do the rest of our work in the Yoast SEO plugin. So now let's go to WordPress. I'm logged in here, and we'll go to Plugins, Add New, and I'm going to search for Yoast, and click Install Now. Then we'll have to activate it. And now it's installed, and it's already telling me that there's an issue. Now, Yoast might present you with a pop-up suggesting that you do the configuration wizard. That's what we're going to do. But if you choose not to do it right then, I'm going to show you how to get back to it. You can find it right here under this icon in the admin bar. Or if you go to SEO in the left, there's a link here to run it. We're going to go ahead and run the configuration wizard. So the first thing we do is click Configure Yoast SEO. And we need to decide whether my site is live and ready to be indexed, or if it's under construction and should not be indexed. Mine is currently live, so I'm going to choose option A. And then it wants to know what kind of site this is. Mine is a blog. And are we a person or a company? If it's a person, put in their name. What you put in here Depends on your site, of course. So you need to be thinking about how you want to present yourself to Google. And here we can connect our social profiles. I would recommend that you put in the URLs for all of your social profiles. I'm going to skip this section because I haven't actually set them up yet for my site. You could do the same. You could skip this section and then later go create these accounts and come back and either rerun the wizard or there's a place in the settings for them. And we'll look at that in a moment. Do we want search engines to show posts in search results and or pages? I'm going to say yes for both of them. Do we have multiple authors? My site is a no. And here we come to the Google Search Console. Now let me talk a little bit more about what this does. The Google Search Console keeps an eye on your website. When Google crawls your site, if it finds any problems, it will log them in the Search Console. It can also make suggestions if it finds malware on your site or if it finds something that slows your site down. Connecting Yoast with the Search Console means that you can get those messages right in your WordPress site so that you don't have to go to the Search Console to see them. Also, Yoast can tell Google when you have new content and ask that it crawl it. All in all, it makes Google much more aware of your site. So we're going to click Get Google Authorization Code. I'm going to log in with the same Google account that I did before. And it says Yoast SEO wants to access your Google account. I'm going to allow this. And they're going to give us this big, long number. We simply copy it and close this window. We paste it in this field right here and click Authenticate. Now we've authenticated with Google, but we haven't told it which website we're working with yet. We've only logged in. So now I click the site that I'm working with and click Next. And now Search Console is connected to this site. Now this page refers to the site title, and that appears in this tab at the top. Now our site title is going to have our page or post name, then a separator, and then the website name. And you can choose any separator you want, and it doesn't really have any bearing on your SEO. This would be purely for cosmetics. We'll choose Next, and here we have the option to sign up for the Yoast SEO newsletter. If you're at all interested in SEO, I highly recommend you sign up. There's some really great information that comes in their newsletter. The final page is a pitch to upgrade to premium. But there's also a number of training videos. These are also excellent if you really want to do a deep dive on Yoast. And now we're done. We'll click Close. And we have some wonderful default settings for Yoast SEO, as well as being connected to the Search Console. But we're not quite done yet. There are a few more things that I'd like to show you. Let's go to Search Appearance. Now this refers to how you appear in search results. Right now, it's site title, page, separator, tagline. I recommend leaving the defaults because Yoast is pretty clever at what they do. But if you needed to change these, you could. You can simply click here and click any one of these. If we go to content types, we can choose some options for each content type. So we're showing posts, but we're hiding the date in the snippet preview. And on posts, we're showing the Yoast SEO meta box. We'll look at that in just a minute. And then this is how it appears. We can do the same for pages, and if you had other content types, you could do the same there as well. Each of these tabs has some wonderful default settings, and I recommend that you read through them, but not necessarily that you change them. Again, Yoast is very clever. Let's look at the Search Console here real quick. And this is where it would show you some information from the Search Console. we don't have any issues right now. But if we go to settings, this is where you could re-authenticate. Every now and again, the authentication fails. Google will try to connect to your site and it'll fail, and so it will disconnect your authentication. That doesn't mean it'll stop working. The console will keep crawling your site, and all you'll need to do is come back in here and click re-authenticate. There's a social tab here, and this is where you can put in your social profiles. Some of them have some custom settings. For example, with Facebook, you can put in a Facebook app ID, and then Facebook will know a lot more about your site. Similar things work for Twitter, Pinterest, and Google+. Under Tools, we can import and export all of your settings. So if you have another site that's very similar to this one, you could export your settings and import them there and be a lot farther ahead. Now, one more thing I want to show you. Now that you have Yoast SEO installed, it'll do some very common things in the background, and it'll do them to all posts and pages. However, when you're creating a new post and page, there are some very important things that you should do. So I'm going to make up a post title here. And then I'm going to come down to this Yoast SEO meta box. And you'll see right here, this is what the search results are going to look like. There's the post title, our separator, and the site name. Then there's the URL, but there's no text here at all. So we can click this and put something in there. Then we also want to put in a keyword. And this is an important word that people might search for to find your post. This is actually a bad keyword, but I'm going to use the word post because it's in my title. So now we have our site title, site name, our post, and a site description. So this is how it's going to look in Google. And that's how it's going to look on mobile. If you click here, you get to see it on desktop. Down here is an analysis of how we did. The text contains 0 words. I didn't write a post. But what's interesting is that it says this is far below the minimum recommended of 300 words. So that's good to know that Yoast expects you to do about 300 words in a post to make Google pay attention to it. My meta description is under 120 characters long. However, up to 156 characters are available. And you can see that with an orange bar here. As I type, it gets longer. And at some point, it turns green. And that's when you're in the happy zone. Now, 156 will be right here and it'll turn red, and then it would cut it off. You can see here how it's getting longer. If I put in a bunch, suddenly it's truncated and there's an ellipsis. That's not necessarily bad, but ideally you want to get it just right. Now, additionally, the SEO title contains the focus keyword, but it does not begin at the beginning. Try and move it to the beginning. The SEO title is too short. Use the space to add keyword variations. So there is some great advice here. And it's important to know that this is advice. These are not requirements. Google's not going to hate you if you don't do all of these things and get a perfect green dot from Yoast. Write your content the way you want it to be written and follow as many pieces of advice as you can without making it feel artificial. Once you're done handcrafting all of the elements here in Yoast, then you can publish your post. Then Yoast is going to let Google Console know that you have a new post, and Google will come crawl it, and it will start showing up in search results. Now this box appears on posts, pages, and optionally every other post type you have. Now let's review real quick. Optionally create a Google account. If you already have one via Gmail or YouTube or whatever, then you can use that one. But then create a Google Search Console account. You don't need to do anything with it, just create it. Then we installed Yoast SEO and follow the install wizard and at some point it's going to ask you to authenticate with Google Search Console. Once we've gone through the wizard and set up some great defaults, then it's time to start handcrafting SEO information about your posts and pages. Now, I showed you how to do it with a new post, but if you already have an existing blog and this is your first time setting it up with Yoast, I recommend going back through your old content and adjusting the keywords and the descriptions and things like that. One last thing about SEO. If this is a brand new website, it's probably not going to start showing up in Google search results for about a year. Google has a policy about that. It doesn't list sites that are younger than a year. Now, it starts watching your site immediately, so you want good SEO, and you want to start now being a good citizen of the web, so that after a year, Google says, this site has now grown up, they have good content, they've had good content for a year, let's start listing them up high. So if you have a new site, start working now on great SEO, and in about a year, you should have great listings. If you'd like to learn more about WordPress, check out winningwp.com.